Okie dokie doke, I think we're up and running. It's cold, cold, cold. Okay, time to get out the paper here and blow my nose. Hang on. Oh boy. Wow. Okay, hello everybody. Long time no see, everyone. Oh. It's been a whole zoo of technical issues and sleep issues and everything else in order for me to get to the point where I'm streaming again. Been a long time since I've done it, so hopefully all goes well. But hello, we are back. We are back, and so we're going to try the format that I attempted one of the more recent streams, which was to open up the construction set, do a little bit of work in there, and then we'll take a break, and I'll switch over drives, actually, my hard drives on my computer, and we'll boot up again, and then we'll go and play some actual game. And I don't know how long this is going to take. I suspect maybe half an hour or so in the construction set, and then we'll spend a couple hours doing some gaming. All going well. So good morning to everybody. So we were working on Erengard Mines. And let's check our change log here. And so we started out in the past with changing over global variables, names of global variables, to make them a little more compact and to align them in accordance with a naming scheme that recognizes the mod they came from in a little more succinct fashion. Now, we're going to attempt to do the same sort of thing with local variables today, and that's going to be trickier. So up comes the plugins that I'm going to work on, and they are multi in number. So we're going to load up each of the plugins in the construction set, and then we're going to load up MW edit, and then we'll load up this changelog again and anything else we need to look at. Maybe enchanted editor, we'll see. But we're going to start with my big main plugin, which is the part of the amalgamation, and it's one of the two huge plugins that are the mainstay of the amalgamation. This one I call MWAM Main. It includes the combination, the merging of Erengard Mines into it. So I do this in a two-step process. I load the vanilla ESMs first. This usually gets dialogue and stuff out of the way. That would otherwise bump and conflict and sort of disappear on me if I tried to load it all at once in the construction set. And I look for where my installation of main is, somewhere down here. Here we are, and choose the latest version. Oh, I just had a thought. 0284A. I better just check and make sure that I'm not actually using that and that I don't have to make a new one. So I'm going to go into my save games here. Saves. It's in here somewhere. There we are. And I'm going to bring up my latest character and just stick a temporary file in there, which I can check against RyMash and make sure I'm not using that very file for this character. So I'll sync to the load list over here and see what I am. Oh yes, right, I'm using that version which I cleaned with test tool with unrestricted cells and dialogues, so we're okay. So to all, clear that out. Okay, so we're good to go. We shouldn't be trading on any save games if I use this file. Okay, so it should be this one here, 284A. And I should be able to tell when I open it up. I'll just check the global variables for ArenGard Mine. If they all look to be different, then that'll be the telling indicator. How's everybody today? It's cool where I live. As in frickin' cool. I'm all bundled up here in my blankets and I'm trying to keep my hands warm. That's when you hear me doing like this. I'm rubbing my hands together because it's chilly in my house. I just live in a little modular, and it's leaky as a sieve, and so kind of clammy inside and cool. But it's like minus 30 degrees Celsius today for a high. Minus 40 with a wind chill. It's crazy. All right, so we have loaded that main plugin. It takes a while to load, as you can see, because it's just so huge. And gameplay globals. And we'll just check VGEM for ArenGard Mine. Yep, looks like these are all the globals that had been changed in the past, so that should be good. Okay. Now, in conjunction with working on the amalgamation, I'm also doing a standalone version of the changes, which is something I can upload in the future once I'm satisfied that it hasn't got any hitches or glitches. And that'll be for everybody else's use, which will hopefully make it a version which is sort of cleaner and neater and faster and more error free, but it's anybody's guess as to whether I succeed in doing that all the time, because sometimes I mess up. As a matter of fact, you know what, I think I'm going to make a copy of this and we'll call it edit 2 as we enter a new stage here. So let me get back into RyMash here, go into my huge mod list of standalones mostly, and we'll call it edit number 2. So I'm going to make a copy, duplicate, do 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 do, and edit 02. There we go. And I'm going to make a little note over here and say global variables. Renamed. Okay, that's the stage we're at here. Okay. That way, in case I mess up what I'm currently doing today, the work that I did before won't be overwritten. By the way, hello to new followers. I see in my mail that I had a couple of new followers here and there while I was not broadcasting. And so thank you. Okay, Iron Guard Mines. Edit 1, edit 2. Here we go. Edit 2, and this will load up a lot quicker. Okay, there's our standalone. Now we're going to load up the original Iron Guard Mines as a reference. Make sure that as I make changes and go along and make changes, I can refer back to this if I need to. I don't expect I'll use this, but and I've labeled it as original. So load it there. Now you notice that as I go down in my list there, everything is alphabetical. That was a trick. Took me quite a while to do that one day, a whole day in fact, I think, where I went in and renumbered date-wise everything so that it also showed up in my list alphabetically. That's kind of anal, I know, but that's me. But it sure makes life a lot easier. So you take that long, big step to begin with to organize your stuff, and it's a pain to go through. Very painful, like extracting a tooth, but then once you're done, you don't know how you ever lived without it. And then I'm loading up the original vanilla game. Here is another reference in case I have to check hyperlinks or something like that. And we'll see how they compare with the original vanilla, if there are overlaps between the mod and vanilla Morrowind. Okay, and that's done. Now we're going to load up MW Edit, maybe once or twice. I think we'll load it up in this is always subject to change. I'm not sure to what I want to apply. MW Edit. But usually I use it for the purpose of searching, a more thorough searching. If you remember from last foray into the construction set here, I showed how MW Edit can often provide for a more thorough search experience than what you get with the construction set alone. Okay, so I think I'll load up the main plugin, and here I'm going to load up the original plugin. And I'm not even going to see with the main one. I also load up a null ESP at the end as well, so that if I accidentally save in MW Edit, it doesn't save to the same work that I'm doing in the construction set, because that would be kind of disastrous. But here in the original plugin, since that's abounds everywhere and is not related to any work that I'm doing, I'm going to make it active and not worry about a null plugin to preserve the save if I accidentally save an MW Edit. I think that's as far as we need to go. We'll see if I change my mind as I go along, depending on what I encounter. Okay, we'll bring up the change log. I'm just thinking here, do I want Enchanted Editor? It might not hurt. Let's just give it a look-see. Data files. Okay, ErinGard Mine Original. And as you can see, the original plugin has a problem right off the top. The headers don't match between the file header for the game and the actual content of the game itself. So one good reason to edit it right then and there. All right, now here comes the, so here's the crux of the problem is number one, trying to find the variables in the first place. Because globals, if you want to find global variables like we did in the last session, it's easy enough to do because they have their own category in terms of the categories that the construction set is organized into. And in Enchanted Editor here, for example, we can just click on that category and bring up the list of globals that's evident there. With the local variables, that's not so straightforward because local variables influence two areas, principally the scripts and dialogue entries. So we're going to have to hunt down any local variables that we want to change by looking through the scripts. So I think that's probably as good a reason as any to bring up Enchanted Editor, so we can motor through these scripts one by one and take a look at the local variables that are present in those, if any. And then we'll do the same for dialogue, although Enchanted Editor won't be as useful for that, but perhaps with MWEdit we can get an idea of which dialogue entries to follow, and then we can chase those down in the construction set. All right, so let's go down here to the original mod to begin with, and that will be giving us the most definitive idea of what local variables are needing to be changed. And as you can see, the author of ErinGard Mine has got a nicely organized system here with the objects that are in the mod preceded by the prefix EM, and I think there's an S there as well, so it should be very easy to hunt down all of the scripts that are included in the mod. Okay, so let's go to the original, and perhaps I'll make a list before I actually do any of the work one at a time, but I might just go in and create a list that I can refer back to for ease of operation. And then we'll get our hands into the actual work after I do that. So away we go, bring up, and I'll start from the bottom and work my way up. EMS supply crate is the bottom one, and the top one should be daily business. Okay, so EMS supply crate and nothing in there. And you can tell what your local variables are just by looking at the declarations at the top of the script. Because usually they're at the top of the script. Sometimes if the script is very long and complex and it maybe includes scripts from other modders that have been included into a combination sort of script in some mods, people actually move or have the declarations scattered throughout the script. Here I don't expect they're going to be that complex. And I'm just looking for anything that's really, really long, really cumbersome looking, really erroneous looking. It looks like it might be terribly conflicting in some way or another. But so far these look pretty succinct and unique to this game, and I am not seeing anything that is jumping out at me as needing too much change. Now, here's one here that I might want to address, because my good old, it's actually not bad. The only consideration that I have here is with the underscore. I do not like the underscore. It tends to lead to problems of one sort or another throughout the game, even if it's just in terms of searching for something. Let me come back to that. I'm just going to make a note of this money chest. If that's the only area in the game that I might want to change, and I might not even, we'll see how extensive those reach, if we can do a thorough search of them. But changing local variables is tricky. And I'm going to preface this further statement with an apology to everybody, because I went ahead and have changed a couple of local variables in such a fashion as I'm looking at here in the Game of the Year Script Tidy. EMG morale, that is a global, is it not? Yeah. Okay, so globals have already been changed. There's no declaration here. That's obviously a global variable. Not to worry. And I noticed when it comes to talking to Arion for House Telvanni, and if you have to go and learn some wizard spells in him, and up comes a left evaluation error, owing, I think, to the change that I made. At least in my game, it does. So I apologize ahead of time for that. I really don't know. I've gone through and I've scoured again what might give rise to that. And I think all the changes I made are valid, but there must be something maybe that I've overlooked. I don't know. I still say that the change I made to that dialogue and that variable in there are probably a good idea, but when it leads to errors like that, you really cringe and say, oh my gosh, what have I done? Because it was probably better off just leaving it alone in the first place. So my grandest apologies to everybody for that, and that's something that's going to have to be looked at in the future. Maybe go back and revisit that script tidy, and it has to be looked at again anyway. There has to be another phase to fix a few more of the dialogue entries that I couldn't get right the first time, mostly around Tribunal. I think there are at least three in there, and then obviously that one with Arion has to be looked at as well. So that's, it's tricky changing local variable, because so they influence many aspects of the game in dialogue and scripts, and they're hard to track down. And if you do change them and you think you've covered all your bases and you still can end up with a left evaluation error and screw everything up. So it's sometimes like only in the most egregious circumstances would I think of changing a variable. And here is one instance where I might like to, because we have a short declared here as I, and to me that is a little bit on the treading on in danger territory. If you put a variable that short there, again, it is the kind of thing, you know, you might not want to mess around with it because local variables go where angels fear to tread. But why am I doing this all in the first place? Well, see now, say you want to look in a big amalgamation like I've got. And you want to ascertain how far ranging, what kind of influence a local variable has on the game overall as a whole, and checking for things like conflicts or whatever. Okay, well, let's do a search and let's see where we find this variable showing up in Morrowind Amalgamation. Using the construction set search engine. Oh gosh, look at where it shows up. It shows up in all these topics and in all these scripts. Tick tock, tick tock. And in all these objects, which are about to come at some point in the future. Anyway, you get my point. You can't track where that variable shows up in the game. It's just prohibitively, I mean, you would spend your whole life, right, just looking for that one variable to find out where it shows up in the game, if it's named in such a fashion. There we go. All these game settings, all the categories that it shows up. It's the letter I, right? And so doing a string search for the letter I, oh, go away. It's sort of ridiculous and impossible. So let me just go back into where I've loaded it up in the MW edit. And I'm going to go down the list here and see where I can find it showing up here. If I can find it showing up by itself. It's in every word, it's in every block here, because there's always a word with an I in it somewhere, a string. Here we are, set I to 0, while I less than EMG guard set I to I plus 1 end while. So it's obviously just a holder. It holds a value for the period of time that it takes to go through a while loop pertaining to some global here. And oftentimes you have to exchange a local variable for a global variable for those things that the construction set won't, or the game won't process as a, it won't process global sometimes. And so you have to do a, you know, set a local to a global, do your operation on a local, then go back and reset the global. kind of an operation, and that seems to be what's going on here. Do I want to change it or not? Yeah, I kind of think I do. It's such a minor little piece to change, but again, I also feel that when the game has to keep track of so many components, and I know it does a very good job of sifting through and parsing and extricating things in terms of whether it's a script or dialogue or an object or whatever like that. I kind of feel, though, that sometimes there's the opportunity for collisions to occur if you use something as simple and as ubiquitous as a letter I for a variable. So I'm kind of inclined to change it just for that basis alone. I don't think I'll do any harm because I'm looking at the statement here. I think that's all that's at work here, is that it's just a little holder for this script and this script alone. But let me go through the other scripts and we'll just see if something like that repeats as a pattern. Or wait a minute, that might have been the last script, eh? Daily business? Oh, we're done anyway. So that's the only one. I think I'm going to take a chance. I think I'm going to change it. Just on the basis of my last statement alone. And just reduce any kind of possibility that it might be confused with something else in the game as the game is running and very, very busy in the course of doing things. Everything else I could see. See, now, one of the things I would do if I was designing a mod is I would not use an actual word that you find showing up elsewhere in the game. As per my original search, as I showed you before, you want to find out where that variable has influence, maybe, as a mod worker. And so you punch in the name of the variable and it shows up as a common word that is apparent in many, many different places besides the plugin that you are working on. For example, the word employee shows up in books put in by the less generic NPC project. So, probably not a swell idea to have a word that is actually going to show up as a text string in areas other than as a local variable in the plugin that's of interest. So, if I was designing the mod, I would probably use a different kind of structure. And quite often, as you know, if you've been following me in the work that I do, I change the prefix to reflect the category of the object that I'm dealing with. So in this case, local variable, if you watched my previous construction set video, it would be VG, standing for variable global, for global variables, and thus the counterpart for local variables would be VL. And so I'd probably put a prefix VL in front of that just to indicate that it's a local variable. And then even without tracking down the variable or anything, I know exactly right off the top what kind of an object it is. It's a local variable. It's assigned to do certain things in the dialogue and the scripts. And then I would use a nonsense string, which is both reflective of what its purpose is, but it also is different enough that it won't appear in, say, books. So it'd be most likely the case I would drop vowels out of it or something. So it'd be E-M-P-L-Y-S or something like that to stand for employees, but with a string that's not going to be found anywhere else in the game. E-M-P-L-Y-S. I mean, how many times are you going to find that kind of string showing up anywhere? And therefore, it's unique to that script and that script alone, or that use of the variable and that variable alone, and then with the prefix VL in front of it, it's going to be even that much less common that it's going to be showing up in a search, or that the game is having to process it and sift it out from other strings of the same name elsewhere in the game as the game is running. So, I think I'm going to change. Heaven help me, but I'm sure it's going to be pretty tame. But before I do any changes like that, now I have to check in other areas where I or some other local variable might be of influence. And of course, that was going to be in the dialogue. So let's get out of this script in the original mod for the time being. And go through some of the dialogue entries. So what are the dialogue entries? So I brought up the original mod in MWEdit. And the nice thing about MWEdit is you can search through dialogue topics and organize them according to the mod that they come from. And they show up nicely and in color. And you can do the same thing, of course, in Enchanted Editor, but it's a little less clear over here when it comes to looking at the individual entries, because it organizes the entries by their ID number, and it's a little bit convoluted to go and find which ID number belongs with which dialogue topic, like this. So I prefer to use MWEdit for that reason alone quite often. So we have here the dialogue topic, Workings of the Mind. Oh dear. Okay, now am I still going? Okay, see, now you get an idea of what I've been having to put up with over the course of the last few weeks or months. A little slurp of coffee here. My display driver just stopped working and recovered. That's a Windows feature. If it detects that your display driver is, for some reason, lagging, then it resets it. Thank you very much to everybody concerned, NVIDIA and Microsoft. I do have a crappy graphics card, apparently. I found a really neat website yesterday, which does benchmarks for your system as a whole, and has a really nice layout. That's, you know, I wish more websites were like that. I can't remember the name of it. I could look it up, but my gosh, it was good and thorough, and I could do pretty much anything. I just stumbled into it, and so it could benchmark my graphics card in comparison with other cards that were compatible with my system, and sort those cards according to, you know, price and value and popularity and all sorts of things. And it was really, really good. So I benchmarked my card against some of the things that would be considered good replacements for it according to the motherboard that I've got, and whoa man, I definitely could use an upgrade, and I've known this from the day that I built this computer, that the graphics card was not the best. The fellow who set me up with it said so. And said that that was sort of the bottleneck in the system, and I can see why he said it. Now that I benchmarked it. So definitely I'm in line for an upgrade. But between that and updates to Windows and NVIDIA software, I've been having crashes all over the place with that stupid card. And that is one of the reasons why I've been offline so long, is because when I try under Windows 7, see, I've got several operating systems, under Windows 7, which is was my go-to for running Morrowind online, it doesn't really work that well anymore. And it could be the graphics card has just, you know, come to the end of its life, who knows, and is giving some hardware errors along the line. Yeah, I just was crashing left, right, and center in Windows 7. But interestingly enough, I go to Windows 10, and this is what I'll be using for the gameplay later today. And seems to be really, really stable. So go figure that, between operating system software and graphics card software. Maybe that's all that's different. I don't know. Knock on wood, but I haven't had any crashes like that under Windows 10. So I'm going to change actually operating systems before I go to Windows 10. Or before I go to gameplay. I'll be changing from Windows 7, which is where I am now, into Windows 10 for the gameplay. All right, so back to changing our variable. So ArenGuard Mine Original. So here we are, the standalone for ArenGuard Mine. And dialogue. Actually, no, I'm going to start with the original dialogue, and I'm going to look through each of those entries of the dialogue to see if there are instances where locals show up that are not evident in the scripts, that are in need of attention. And so, what were they? Workings of the mine. Nothing there. Tasks. Supply crate. Statistics. All right, here we are. We've got EMG cost, EMG theft, EMG revenue. These again, I believe, are globals, which we've already addressed. Cost, revenue, theft, yeah. Okay, so all going well. These variables have been changed properly in that topic, in our standalone and in our amalgamation. And since I'm in the vicinity anyway, I thought I might just take a peek and see. Yep, looks like we're all changed accordingly. That's good. All right. Back to locals again. Next topic is rail and mining carts. So actually, this is probably going to end up being a nothing video. You've gotten a lot of theoretical information from me, but no actual hands-on work. Again, that's a global, I believe, in all cases. Those should have been changed properly, I would imagine. Let's do a little bit of quality check as we go by. So it doesn't look like I'm actually going to get my hands really dirty in this session today. But as I say, you've got some theoretical information and that might be all you're going to get out of this session. Purchase spirits. And again, it looks like it's only influencing globals in that case. EMG account, which keeps track of the amount of money that you've got at your disposal in the operation here of buying various things in the mine. Okay, nothing jumps out at me that looks like it's local in any of these cases. I think it's all globals. Which we've already done in the last session. Okay. Owner. And I have to stress how important it is. This is boring to watch, I know. But I have to stress how important it is to be thorough. And I'm actually not being as thorough as I could be. So I'm sort of glossing over a few things here that look like they are... Just say, oh, that looks like a global. That looks like a global, but I should be really going very, very thoroughly and slowly. But I think this the number of local variables that are in question in this game are very few and far between in this plugin. Yeah. Morale. There are going to be other plugins that I might do in the future online here just to show you a little more about. This is because I'm working sight unseen in this. This is not really, I haven't really set this up as a illustrative instructional sort of video. This is sort of work in progress kind of video. And there goes my driver again. It's really, really, really. Okay. I'm leaning toward I'm going to have to buy a graphics card sooner rather than later. Kind of feeling in my bones right now. So owing to the fact that this has been just more or less a theoretical exercise going along here, and owing to the fact that I seem to be losing my equipment all over the place. I may just stop this portion of the broadcast right here and address some of this work offline. But I'll just give you a brief description of how I would go about making a change here. And that is to say, I would probably go back into, as I say, the maybe the couple of scripts here that I thought could be addressed that had the such as this one here that had the variables in question. I might just make a couple of quick changes there. So I think for the short here, the short I would probably name it something like VL maybe even put the name of the mod in front of that as a prefix, EM II or something. I really don't think that's going to show up anywhere in the world as a string that you're going to encounter. And so it's going to be unique. There it is in my main plugin. It just doesn't register. So it's a little bit longer, a little bit more verbose as a string for the game to get through, but it's not going to be that much of a more onerous burden on it in terms of how much longer it's going to make this script or anything. And at the same point in time, I think it'll be just a little bit more unique to this plugin and this plugin alone. And for that reason alone, I might change it. And the other one was the gold with the underscore in it. I might just change that to truncate it a little bit, get rid of the underscore. And that one's going to be a little bit more tricky because one of the reasons I don't like an underscore is because if I wanted to search and see the influence that that kind of variable had, now which script was it? This one, haha. Good guess. If I wanted to do a search for that in some kind of an export or something like that, and I went through in, I don't know, some kind of a text editor outside of the game, maybe going through the dialogue or something like that, the search might be cut off at the underscore, and so you only get this showing up in the search, gold underscore, and it won't be differentiated according to what's after the underscore. So things like that, when I see the underscore in it like that, I get a little bit it impinges on my os my ODC. My OCD. Obsessive compulsive nature. And again, I don't think these variables are going to influence anything other than this script, but that alone gives me a little bit of comfort to know that, you know, they're a little bit more in line with how I like them. I don't know. Let me just show you that I would go about searching for those variables. At least a couple of times. First of all, in the text search in the construction set, and also in MW Edit. And that would be a more general search in here, which does an actual string search, unlike the construction set, which operates in a slightly different fashion. It's sort of an associative search. So gold, gold amount. So to search through MW Edit for a string like that, you would have to type it in literally using your keyboard and then go find. And in both cases, in the construction set and in MW Edit, it seems that it only shows up in the script. And that is about as thorough a search as I can get when I search for a local variable. And that's a little bit scary, and that may be what led to some of the problems in the ScriptTidy, the Game of the Year ScriptTidy mod that I put out, which led to a left evaluation in that discussion with Arion regarding the wizard spells. And maybe there's something I missed, because really, outside of a text search in the construction set and a string search in MW Edit, that's basically about all that's going to yield any kind of results as far as searches, and they may or may not be complete in terms of what they find. And so that's why I'm going through fairly carefully, but not super carefully, but fairly carefully, topic by topic throughout the dialogue, which, as I say, is kind of boring in that, but it really begs for you to be as thorough as you can possibly be in doing something like this in order to find something like a local variable, because the searches may or may not give the complete picture. And so that's what that's all about. So minor 5 item, EMS minor 5 item. Huh? What was that? Oh, that's the scripts. Pardon me. I went back to the scripts instead of the dialogue. Dialogue. Here we go. Hire a miner. Where are we at? Money chest. Okay. Money chest is where we left off. Get them alphabetical here. Money chest. Okay. Miners is the next topic. Talk about frustrating. Well, it seems to be that our driver has not failed in the last couple of minutes, so maybe I'll continue on here. Hire an overseer. But boy, oh boy, talk about trying to play the game when it's doing that kind of nonsense. And you get it crashing all over the place like that, and I'll tell you. Pretty good. Hire a miner, hire a guard. Again, these look to be pretty much all global, except where we see picks here. It says local picks. And that is one word that, again, while I'm not particularly thrilled with the fact that it's the same kind of word as you would find elsewhere in the game, things could be worse. It's not really going to be a super, super common word. And I think in that case, I'm going to let sleeping dogs lie. It doesn't have an underscore in it. And probably more trouble than it's worth to change that particular variable. So I think I'm going to leave picks alone and others like it. Just the two in question there, the gold with the underscore after it, and that one short that's only the letter I are the only ones that I might put my hands on. And that in general is the policy for local variables, I would say, is just if it looks reasonable, leave it alone. If it looks a little bit on the sketchy side, maybe do something about it. But if it's, yeah, it's better to tread lightly when it comes to changing local variables. Global's a little easier to track down and find where they show up and the kind of influence they have. So I didn't feel too bad, I don't think, about changing the global variables too much, but and they're easy enough to fix if you have made an error. Locals, on the other hand, as evidenced by that left evaluation in Arion's dialogue, looks like I probably should have left that one alone, but that's hindsight. Food barrel, fire an overseer, fire miner, fire a guard, probably the same sort of thing as before. Just globals. And so this is a pretty simple mod, really. In terms of the kinds of variables it uses, and it's actually a well laid out mod to begin with, so there isn't a whole heck of a lot to be done here. And Arengard Mines. I'm just using my up arrow key to go up topic by topic, or entry by entry. EM Arengard deed, that's an item. Okay. Okay. So I'm pretty satisfied that there's no influence of those local variables in the dialogue. And the only time really a local variable shows up is for mining picks with the word picks. And so, okay, well, you know what? I'm gonna make a change. Let's do a change, and I'll show you how I go about doing that. And then we're gonna shut this down. I gotta get out of this crashy environment. Okay, so the script in question, two scripts. But I found them, and one was the EMS money chest, which is the note that I made for myself, which I forgot about, but which was clever of me. So script EMS money chest. I don't think I've changed any script names yet. I think we're just changing the contents of the scripts. And then in our next session, we will probably go with changing script names. There are a couple of things that I would like to change about them. And so, we will do that exercise. Okay, so I found the script name in question that I want to make changes to. And I'm pretty sure that pretty sure as I can be That leaves local variables are confined to this script and this script alone. So the only changes I'm going to make are going to be to the actual contents of this script. Okay, but once again, I've done a search through the dialog on a case-by-case basis, and I've done a broad search in both the construction set, text finder, and in MWEdit string finder. And in all cases, it looks like that local variable only pertains to this script. And I'm going to check the other locals while I'm at it. We've got cold pre. PRE in MWEdit, only in this script. And gold pre. See, now if I want to double click and choose that whole variable, I can't. And this is one of the reasons I don't like underscores, is because here I go. I'm putting my mouse over top of that variable. I double click to try and get the definitive string into memory by going control copy, but I can't. I double click on it, I only get a partial choice of that variable on one side of the underscore or the other. Hence, part of my reason why I dislike underscores. And again, according to the text search in the construction set, it only shows up in that script. And according to our search in the string section of MWEdit, it only shows up in that chest. So I'm as confident as I can be that it only shows up in this script. So I think I'm just going to, for the sake of succinctness and functionality, I'm going to change the variables in the script and hope that I don't wreck anything else elsewhere in the plugin. Okay, so we're going to look for gold amount. And we're going to make a note in our changelog of these variables that I'm going to change. I'm going to change gold amount. I'm going to change gold diff. And I'm going to change gold pre. And I might as well make a note of the original script that they come from in case I want to track down my change for any reason in the future. I'm just copying and pasting here. All right, gold amount. So what are we going to call it? How about GLDAMT, GLD, and again, I could put VL in front of it, but I don't think that's really, in this case, I'm going to go for something a little more straightforward, because I don't think these variables have that much influence on the plugin other than what they do in this script. So if I just change it to something like this, that'll probably be sufficient in my mind for making them different enough, but the same enough, if you know what I mean. Okay, so then we go into MWEdit. Find that script, and we bring up our search and replace box, and we put in one that we're going to start with, which is gold amount, And again, I got to swipe it. I can't double click it, unfortunately. And I'll put it in there and make sure I don't have any extraneous spaces on either side or anything. There we go, gold amount. And then we'll change it to what I can double click on. My nice little variable name there. So we'll do a search and replace through this script one item at a time. Because again, being that it's got an underscore in it, who knows how many other variables sort of share this structure. So rather than hit replace all, I think I will do a find next and hit them all manually, one at a time. Won't take that much more time. And I could go match whole word only and like that, but I think I'll try to keep my search a little broader. And as I say, just do it manually for precision's sake. So gold amount, now I find it and I hit R, 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 R. And it looks like that's the end of that variable. All right, next one, gold diff. Copy that, go to the top of the script, reset your search and replace by hitting cancel. Clean it right out and then put your next parameters in. Make sure there's no extraneous spaces or anything. Find next and R for replace. Okay, and gold pre. Clean out the box. Copy, go to the top of the script. Paste it into the box, go and get a replacement. Double click, copy. Put it into the box. Find next, hit R. There we go. Now just a brief scan of the whole script, make sure it all makes sense. So here you can see we have a global variable over here, and I know it's a global variable because I put the prefix VG in front of it for variable global. So that's one of the reasons I do that is, you know, I can tell, and if I wanted to, as I say, differentiate the locals more, I don't think it's worth it in this script, but if I did want to, I'd put a VL in front, and immediately upon looking at it, I'd know exactly what kind of an object it is, according to the prefix. But as I say, I think I'm going to skip over that for this particular exercise, and we'll just go with something without the underscore and a little more truncated, but still very much similar to what it was to begin with. Okay, so I think we're okay. And in fact, since only objects within the script have been changed, and there's no danger, I think, of finding that this variable has influence elsewhere in the plugin that I'm not aware of, I think it's probably safe to say I can go ahead and do a compile with mwedit and check for errors within the script itself here and be confident that if I find no errors that I can go ahead and plug the script in to my plugins that I'm changing, that I'm altering, and I can be fairly confident, I think, that it's all's going to be in order elsewhere. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to copy all my contents from here. Hi, Danae. How are you doing today? I'm just about ready to wrap this up. This is me changing a few local variables in a couple of the scripts for the Arengard mine. And I've gone through a whole spiel about the do's and don'ts, or the reasons I want to do this in the first place. Ahead of time, if you have any specific questions about this insanity that I'm doing, fire away. Otherwise, I'm just going to go ahead and continue on with my exercise here, and then we're going to wrap this up and we'll get into some gameplay a little bit later. Not really troubleshooting. I'm just putting things into, because the Arengard mine, as far as I can tell, has very little in the way of trouble associated with it. But I'm just putting it into a form that is more compliant with my amalgamation project. So I'm truncating the names of these local variables a little bit, because in the original they show up like this. With an underscore, and I was just explaining to everybody how I'm not a big fan of the underscore, especially when it comes to things like local variables. So I've just changed it over, and I've done as thorough a search as I can muster into how far ranging these variables extend throughout the game, and I've ascertained that they belong to this script and this script alone. So I think I'm okay to go ahead, and I'm just truncating them a bit, getting rid of the underscore, so that they just look a little bit neater and don't give problems as arise with the underscore in what I deem to be problems anyway. So I'm kind of, you know, fixing what isn't broken, if you want to call it that, which can lead to problems. I know, I understand, and I'm aware of that, but I'm going to take the chance and go ahead with this anyway, because I think this is going to be a fairly simple change that isn't going to wreck anything. Of course, that comes out in the gameplay. We test it during gameplay and testing processes to make sure that that is, in fact, the case, that I haven't wrecked anything. But at least I've documented my changes so that I can go back and unchange if I have to. And yes, asking for trouble, pretty much exactly right. Good way of putting it. Okay, ooh. Now what have I got here? I left off. I've done something, have I not? Oh, I better go back and check that offline. Make sure I finished my previous operation altogether. Okay, so there's that one. Now, let's do one more quickly. Let's do that one for daily business. But anyway, yeah, I think we're good there. And daily business. Okay, we'll copy it over. So in the next sessions, we're going to be doing things like changing journal entry names, changing script names, and then further on, we'll probably work on changing NPC names, and we will then go through the final steps of doing a tidy of this mod, the Arengard mine. Final script will be to go through and make changes in accordance with how I like to see the scripts laid out and the dialogue laid out. The formatting of it as it were. And as you can see right off the top here, I've got two different scripts showing up here. They're going to have two different forms, because the one for the amalgamation, I have already in the past changed the IDs of liquors, and so as you can see, the liquor section and the food and things that are included to be used by the miners, I've already changed in a past edit in terms of gameplay desires to be different from what was in the original. So as you can see, it's much more in accordance with vanilla here in the original mod. And there are fewer items included in the set of items that are utilizable by miners to be eaten and drunk. You can see I've got a great many more food items and a great many more liquors that can be utilized by the miners in the amalgamation as opposed to in vanilla. Okay. So we're going to have to change these scripts independently from each other, is what I'm saying. Pause for coffee. Okay. So for EMS Daily Business in the main plugin, we'll go to this load of MW Edit, put it in there, and we're going to change I. Make a note of it in our change log. And I'll even put the name of the script there, the original name. Which I don't normally do, but I think that's a good policy. I'm going to try to make a point of doing from here on in the future. Refer back to the original script that the changes are made to, or dialogue entries or something. So what are we going to call this? Okay, in this case, I think I'll put VL in front of it. VL. How about IX? Just choose something out of the blue, but a little bit more unique. And I'll check that it's unique by going into the text search. Aha! It's not unique, so I guess I won't use that. Okay, good thing I checked. How about VL... I could use anything. I could go XX, but I will go, how about VLEMXI? That's making it considerably longer than it used to be. But again, it's going to be making it that much more unique to Arengard Mines and nowhere else in the game. So let's try that with the prefix of the actual, there you go. A prefix belonging to the actual plugin itself. And so in that case, we should be distinguishing that string from any other string elsewhere in the game. And again, for the operation that it's going to be working on, hardly seems worth the effort. But if nothing else, this shows you the procedure I go through to do the changes that I do. In cases where it might be more impactful. Okay, so clear out the search and replace, give a fresh one here. And this is going to be interesting because I'm going to be putting find what? Find I. And of course, as we've pointed out and shown and demonstrated, I shows up in all sorts of places, in all sorts of strings. So hence, what I'm hoping for to make this without wrecking anything in the process, hopefully make this more distinguishable. And as I found before, I think it only shows up in that one block right there. Okay, let me bring it up a little better visually. Okay, find next set eyes. So here's where we do our replacement, right there. There. Oops, I skipped over. See, I gotta be very careful. So while the process is quite painful right here and now, in future, if I ever wanted to make a change to that variable for some reason or another, and again, I probably wouldn't in this script, but there might be cases in other mods where I do want to make changes to the local variable. Now, if I want to find it, look what I have to do here. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. There it is, and nowhere else. Easy as that. Hence, I do this crazy stuff that I do, asking for trouble, and make the changes. But short-term pain for hopefully long-term gain is the idea here. Okay, so since, again, that probably is a change that occurs here and here only, looks like I've done the wrong script in the wrong editor. So I got to be very careful about where I put this change, which is back into the original, which is now a standalone with edits, but the original looking script. And I'm going to save it twice. Now, let's go back to doing the one that I thought I was doing in here, in the load for the amalgamation, and we will use the same parameters that I used before, put the I there, and put the new name there. And go. Now this is going to take quite a while. Make sure I'm at the top of the script. Go find, because there are a lot more objects in here than there were in the previous script. So let's go find and be very careful about where we hit replace. And I expect that this will be in the same block here as there were in, as it was in the previous script, but I just want to make sure, and I will go FFFFF all the way through, because I don't know if I've made any changes in the past to the amalgamated version of that script, other than the objects that are in the food barrel. So I'm going to go carefully one at a time, and here's where we find our first instance in that block that I was talking about. Replace, 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 replace. And that should be it. But again, let's be thorough, and I'm going to go through the whole rest of the script. Find, find, find. Make sure I haven't made any other changes in the past that I've forgotten about. That should be it. Okay. And now we can do a mock compilation in MWEdit. And it says zero warnings, zero errors. So I copy it all. Paste it back into the construction set in the proper plugin. There we go. 1, 2, 3, save. Let's pray we don't get a crash on my video driver in the course of doing this, in the middle of a save. That would really, really not be good. And that's it. That's our change of local variables session for the Arengard mine. And that's where we're going to leave the construction set for today. And we're going to take a 10-minute break. We're going to get our sandwich and coffee and go to the washroom and all that good stuff. And I got to change my drive over. I've got to go to my Windows 10 drive. And we'll load up PER. And we'll do some gameplay. And we'll hopefully not get crashes on our graphics card in the course of doing that. But so far, so good. Anything I've done under Windows 10 with Morrowind, as far as gameplay, seems to have been very stable thus far. So, knock on wood. Okay. Thank you, Danae, and enjoy your work. I hope things are going well for you. And I'm pretty pleased with the way the session has gone in terms of instructionality. I think we've covered all the bases about why I do things and how I go about doing them and the actual doing of them and the execution of those changes. Very simple as they may be and very non-invasive as they may be. And yet I think it gets the point across in a simple fashion. And sometime in the future, maybe we'll go into mods that are more complex in terms of the wide-ranging appearances that the variables make throughout the plugins, whereas these were just very, very, looked like very basic in-script changes to these variables. We didn't have to worry about dialogue or anything like that. So very straightforward, very simple, and I think successful. Knock on wood, again, I hope everything went well. So we're just going to save everything out now, and I'll maybe make a backup of the standalone. And then we'll come back and do gameplay. Okay, so there I've saved the change log. We don't need an enchanted editor anymore. And we don't need MW edit anymore. So I'm going to back out of all of these as gracefully as I can. We never did use this. This is the vanilla game loaded in the construction set. Here's the original Arengard mine loaded in the construction set. And we won't save any changes that we made there. And where we will save is here. This is our standalone. And I've saved this script a couple of times. Now let's get out into a different script just to change fields. And close it out. And I'll just do a little jig here. Whoops. And same thing for MWAM main. I think I saved this a couple of times. Better do it one more just to make sure. Our main amalgamation. Change fields. Close it out. Do a little hitch. One, two, three, save the standalone. One, two, three, exit. One, two, three, save the amalgamation. Much bigger save. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Hard drive is still working on it. There we go. Looks like it's complete. And we'll close it out. Success, I think. And then we'll go into RyMash to reset the dates. Back to their, quote, original value instead of today's date, which is what the construction set will save it as. There we go. RyMash. Modified dates have been reset for some mod files. So they're back to their original dates. There we go. Okay, back in about 10, guys. We're going to load up our game, our actual game. So if you want to come back for that. And then we'll see you there. And I hope you've gotten something out of this little session here. And I'm going to stop the stream because I want to separate this video from my gameplay video. And perhaps have something that I can upload to, say, YouTube or whatever. Okay, so I'm stopping the stream and we'll be back in 10 minutes. And thank you for joining me for this episode of the construction set. And we'll talk to you in a little bit. Bye-bye.